Aloha everyone and welcome back to the CO2 Rundown. I'm your host, Chad Owens. I hope you guys had an amazing weekend. Whew, it was a very special one for me. I'll get into that later, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys reset, relaxed, and recovered, and are off to an amazing start this week. And I hope you hit that gas pedal. It's about that fast start, right? We gotta build that momentum so you can set up that winning week. Before we get into it, you know I have to say mahalo to Long's Drugs for all of their support. Let's continue to support local and make Long's Drugs a part of our day. Let's dive on in to the CO2 Rundown. Hawaii's very own Isaiah Kainerfalefa is living his dream. Literally, as a child, he grew up idolizing Derek Jeter and those pinstripe uniforms of the New York Yankees. This was back when he was 11 and 12 years old, and they became the first Hawaii team to win the Cooperstown Championship out there in New York. He got a chance to watch those guys practice and sort of just, you know, dreaming that one day he's gonna be playing for that team wearing the pinstripe uniforms. And here he is, you know, a veteran in the major leagues, now playing and starting at the same position as Derek Jeter, the guy he idolized, right? Now he's doing his thing at shortstop, utilizing his athleticism, his hard work, and according to manager Aaron Boone, his gritty toughness. And I feel like every athlete from Hawaii sort of has that gritty toughness. When we're out there, we just want to prove something. We carry Hawaii on our backs, and we have that gritty toughness, that work ethic, and it's sort of that warrior mentality, I'd like to call it. And look, you know, Isaiah, he's had a successful major league career so far, but I think where he's at now, his childhood dream team, and he's surrounded by a lot of talent. In that atmosphere, like you're just gonna elevate yourself that much more. You've heard me say this before, you know, competition, you know, the iron sharpens iron type of things. But when you're in a situation where you are literally where you've always imagined, making it to the major leagues, yes, number one. Making it to the pinnacle of your sport, your profession, that's always number one. But if you can somehow achieve your dream, it just gives you almost like an extra relaxed feeling, like I'm here, not get comfortable because we can't take our foot off the gas pedal when we get there, but just gives you that opportunity to, this is what I've worked my entire career for, my entire life for, and I'm here, and I'm gonna take full advantage of it, I'm gonna enjoy myself, and that's the main thing. Once you're having fun doing what you love, it's not work. You know, it's not a job. You don't like, oh man, I gotta get up and go to work. It's not that type of feeling. You look forward to getting up. You actually work harder when your mind, body, spirit, everything is in that sort of like cohesive sort of feeling. And so Isaiah, as a former professional athlete myself, one who's accomplished the goal and my dream of making it to professional, yeah, I mean, there's the ideal dream situation, team, position, all the things, but regardless, making it, I loved it, I enjoyed it, but to you, man, to really be living out that dream, providing inspiration to so many up-and-coming baseball players here in the islands, I just wanted to say mahalo for that. Continue to do your thing, continue to represent to the fullest. Good luck, brother. Keep doing your thing. Aloha. High school football here on the islands kicked off last weekend, and boy, I'm just gonna tell you this. The defending champs, the Kahuku Red Raiders, believe it or not, look better than they did last year. Well, that's because they got confidence. They've got back a lot of their starters, the returners, and they defeated Kamehameha 49-0. You know, we talk about the eras of high school football, right? Of course, in the state, St. Louis comes to mind. Tops in the states, they've had their runs. Even Kahuku had its spurts here and there. But wow, this is a dynasty in the making. I've said this before, I'm gonna continue to say this. That community, right, out in Laie, Kahuku, that support system, the feeling of, hey, I'm representing more than just myself. They're very fortunate, right? Those football players, that school, those sports teams, they're very fortunate because they have that sort of family, community. It's like its own little town, right? And everyone buys in, everyone shows up. The pride, the school spirit and personal pride there is unmatched. And I think they need to be made an example of, like, that's how it should be. So each and every high school, we should look at teams like Kahuku, right, and rally around our school, right? Your community should be rallying around that program. And that's what helps breed success, in my opinion. You know, you need talent. You know, coaches at the high school level, there's a lot of great coaches around, you know, but you need talent. And there's a lot of talent here on the islands. The one thing I love about what I'm seeing is that a lot of different schools, different divisions are becoming more and more competitive. Now, a 49-0 game doesn't seem very competitive, but let's just be honest. This is just after, you know, a few weeks of practice, week one, game one. Kamehameha is going to bounce back. They're going to make the adjustments. Or we're not going to be defined by one game or one play. Or that's what a lot of our coaches have always preached to us. But Kahuku, yeah, very scary this year. We'll see who's going to dethrone the Red Raiders. But it's going to be an exciting season coming up for all football teams. I cannot wait. Curtis Moriyama has an article in today's Honolulu Star-Advertiser highlighting the NFL's Deshaun Watson, quarterback of the Cleveland Browns, former Houston Texan, who is in a battle right now with the NFL for his potential 30 sexual misconduct lawsuits. Now, look, without diving so deep into this, right, this has been an ongoing thing for a few years, and it's unfortunate, man. Like, there's been incidents in the NFL with players in similar situations that got worse penalties, right? Fined, you know, suspended indefinitely, right? Ray Rice can never play on an NFL team ever again. And, you know, some are saying, okay, with Watson's case, you know, what's taking so long? Why is he getting this type of treatment? Why did he even still get paid? There's all of these things up in the air. And again, it's unfortunate because the guy is so talented. Deshaun Watson is one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL. He's proven that while his time in Houston. But, you know, it's so hard to be a professional athlete. It is. There's a lot of distractions. There's a lot of things that you come across. And, you know, just take this as a learning lesson. You know, I'm talking to my young athletes right now, high school, college. You know, there's a lot of examples of guys and girls of how you should go about your days, how you should operate, the things you should and shouldn't do. And at the end of the day, I believe, hey, everyone's human and we all make mistakes. We do. No one's perfect. But it's just unfortunate that, you know, when you're at the in the NFL, the NBA, that the highest levels, right, the WNBA, you know, there's things going on right now in all sports. When you're at the pinnacle, when you're at the top, the eyes are on you, always, right? You could be, you know, the same situation could happen to a non-NFL player, and maybe you never hear about it. And there has been cases that you've never heard about. But because you're an NFL player, there's a lot of money there. Right? There's potential to, you know, do things to, you know, whatever. Again, without getting too far into it, I just want this to be an example. Not a bad example. I'm not saying that Deshaun Watson is in the wrong. I'm just saying, as an athlete, right? We're always being watched. We're always being criticized. We're always being judged. And so, if you're going to be judged, right, let's make sure we do everything the right way. Have that professional approach. When you're on the field, hey, we're trying to impress our coaches. We're trying to win a job, trying to win a spot. You got to take that same mindset when you're off the field, off the court, when you're walking, going to the grocery store. Hey, I'm trying to win the respect of the people here. I'm trying to be kind. Right? I'm trying to show myself as an amazing human being. I preach to my kids all the time, hey, becoming a pro is good. Hey, become a pro athlete, but let's be a pro person. Okay? And so, just wanted to throw that out there. If you guys want to dive deeper, and it is a lengthy article, it's a lot of nuts and bolts, go take a look. Curtis Moriyama has more in today's Honolulu Star-Advertiser. More Title IX love, as today we're highlighting University of Hawaii Rainbow Wahine head coach Robyn Ah Mow. And I'm just going to start off with this. Even the greats need a little bit of a nudge from time to time. And I'm talking about Robyn Ah Mow post-University of Hawaii playing career. She was in the midst of, okay, what's next? And she sought out former UH Wahine herself and Olympian Deidre Collins, who suggested to Coach Ah Mow, you need to get to Colorado. Go train at the Olympic Training Center in Colorado and get your stuff together. Get right. You are that good. You deserve it. So yes, Robyn Ah Mow headed to Colorado, trained, and led to a, you know, decade of international playing career where she gained a lot of experience and a lot of knowledge and got to travel the world. You know, as it is, that's one of our dreams, all of our dreams. We want to travel the world. And for me as well, sports provided an opportunity to travel places, especially coming from Hawaii. As head coach Robyn Ah Mow did, you know, you become that homebody. You're not trying to leave the islands, right? We get attached, home, food, family. But took the step, went out and did that. And all of that knowledge, all of that time, you know, experiencing, stepping outside of the comfort zone, but at the same time doing what she loved, playing the game of volleyball, brought all of that back and has set the foundation for where she is now. All right, the success she's having as a head coach. It just speaks volumes to, again, a woman in a leadership position didn't just arrive. That doesn't just happen, right? You go through the process, you go through the grind, you go through the ups, the downs, and you have to make tough decisions in life, right? Traveling and deciding to go to Colorado was a thought, and then it took someone else encouragement to say, no, this is what you have to do. You need to do that. But we all need that uplift. We all need that extra motivation from time to time. And I know head coach Robyn Ah Mow is excited and happy that Deidre Collins provided that for her. And now she's reciprocating that back to her players, passing that on and pushing them to be their very best. Hence why they are at the top of the league each and every year. So with that, I want to shout out head coach Robyn Ah Mow. Congratulations on all your success and good luck, because I know there's a lot more success to be had for our Rainbow Wahine. Good luck in the upcoming season. Okay, I alluded to it in my intro. I had a very amazing weekend, a very special weekend. And since we're on the Title IX, I'm going to give this special woman her flowers today. And that's my wife, Rena Owens. This past weekend was the Ikaika Classic. It was a bodybuilding competition here locally where a lot of these athletes competed from different divisions, you know, men's bodybuilding, classic physique, men's physique, women's bikini, women's wellness, and all the different divisions, all the different age groups. A lot, about 50 competitors total at the Hawaii Theater, and it was an amazing show. And my wife entered her very first bikini competition. And I just wanted to, again, give her flowers and say how proud I am of you for stepping outside of your comfort zone. You know, a lot of women, moms, naturally put themselves last. That's just the instincts, right? The mom instinct is to provide for others, is to make sure everyone else is taken care of. But in this industry, as an athlete, especially in the bodybuilding, for women in the bikini, it's tough. It's a lot of discipline, from the workouts to your dieting. And let me tell you, I was watching her, I was with her every step of the process, and it was very, very impressive and inspiring to witness. And, you know, so, baby, I just want to lift you up and congratulate you on doing that. You looked unbelievable up there, amazing. And I know this is just the beginning. I know you're on fire for more. And I just want to also shout out the rest of the competitors. It takes a lot to step on that stage, number one, to be judged, to be in front of people. It takes a lot to be up there. And I know it takes even more to prepare, to grind day in, day out. It's not easy. So congratulations to you all. You guys are all winners because you guys went through the process, went through the grind, and fearlessly stepped on that stage. Although there's anxiety, there's nerves, but you're still out there. You put yourself out there. You put your, you know, you're very vulnerable, and you just did it for you. All right. And I know I spoke to it as a mother, but I know some of you aren't parents that were stepping on that stage, and it's still tough, right? And it's, hey, you got to put yourself first sometimes, and you got to go after the things that make you uncomfortable. Be comfortable being uncomfortable. Congratulations again to my queen, Mrs. Rena Owens. And that is it for today's show. I want to thank you all so much for tuning in on this beautiful Monday afternoon. Hope you have started fast. Like I alluded to in my intro, you gotta be on the gas pedal. You gotta come out the gate. Okay, build that momentum for the week. Mahalo again for Long Drugs for All and your support. Make Long Drugs a part of our day. See you guys on Wednesday. Aloha.